Okay, class, this is the video for section 2.3, solving linear equations. So in this video, it's about 15 problems, and we're going to start them. And they're a little bit more complicated equations, so we'll just go ahead and get started. So remember, when you have parentheses here, to get rid of them, you need to distribute. So 2 times x is 2x, 2 times 3 is 6. Then to solve this equation, I need to get the constant to the other side. So I'm going to minus 6 on both sides. I get 2x by itself equal to 10. Then I can get rid of the multiplier here by dividing by 2 on both sides, which gives me 5. And then if I want to check my answer, I'm going to plug that 5 in for x. So we have 2 times 5 plus 3 equal to 16. 5 plus 3 is 8, 2 times 8 is equal to 16, and so this answer is correct. And so the answer is 5. Now here, same thing, I want to distribute my 6 to get rid of this parentheses. Now my x's are here, which means my constants need to be on the right. So I'm going to add this 6 to get the constant over there to the right. Now I have 30x equal to 36. To get rid of the multiplier of 30, we're going to divide both sides by 30. 30 is now gone on the left, and 36 over 30, if you type that in the calculator, it will spit out 6 over 5. And so the answer is 6 over 5. So what I did was I did 5 times that 6 over 5, which means the 5s cancel. So I have 6 minus 1, which is 5, and 6 times 5 is 30. So it does check out. Number 3, again, we have parentheses, but notice it's the negative that needs to be distributed, okay? Not the 8. There's a minus sign in between these two things. You have to do the multiplication before you can do the subtraction. So I'm going to take this as a negative invisible 1 times these two things. So the 8 comes down, negative 1 times x is negative 1x. You could put the 1 there if you want or not. Negative 1 times positive 6 is negative 6. Then I can combine the 8 and the negative 6, so that's where I got the positive 2. Now I do have variables on both sides, so like I said, I always want to move them over to the left. So this is a positive 5x, so I minus 5x to move it over. Negative 1x minus 5x is actually negative 6x. My plus 2 came down and my negative 4 came down. Now I have x's all on the left side, I need to get all the constants over to the right side. So I'm going to do the opposite, which is minus 2 on both sides. So I get negative 6x by itself, and negative 4 minus 2 is negative 6. Then I divide by this number, because that's my multiplier. So I divide both sides by negative 6. That cancels the negatives and the 6s here, so I have x all alone. And negative 6 divided by negative 6 in the calculator is 1. And so my answer here is 1. Now, number 4 has parentheses on both sides. So we're definitely going to distribute this 21, and we're going to distribute this 15. So I end up with 399 minus 21x equal to 75x plus 15. I do have x's on both sides, so I'm going to move these over there. So these are positive 75x, which means I'm going to subtract 75x on both sides. So 399 stays put. Negative 21 minus 75 is going to be negative 96. And I was combining x's, so it's negative 96x. These are gone here now, so those are wiped out. I brought my positive 15 down. Because my x's are on the left-hand side, I need to move the constant over to the right-hand side. So in order to move a positive 399, I have to subtract 399 on both sides. So that will make the 399 go away here, leaving me with the negative 96x, and positive 15 minus 399 is a negative 384. Finally, I want to get rid of this negative 96 multiplier, so I divided both sides by negative 96. That would make the negatives and the 96s go away, leaving me with x all alone, and negative 384 divided by negative 96 turned out to be just 4, positive 4. And finally, for number 5, it's got parentheses on both sides and some extra numbers. So let's see where we go. So we're going to distribute the 5, which gives me 20x minus 35. And this guy came down. equal, distribute this 5x minus 20, and then the 70 came down. Now I can combine my constants. So this is 20x, and those two together make negative 40. This is 5x, negative 20 plus 70 is positive 50. Then I have x's on both sides, so I want to move these over to the left. So instead of positive 5x, I did minus 5x on both sides. That gave me 15x minus 40, that's gone, equal to 50. Now I have to get the constant over to the other side. So instead of minusing 40, I'm going to add 40 on both sides. That'll get rid of the 40 here, giving me 15x. And then 50 plus 40 is 90. I need to get rid of the 15 multiplier. So I divided both sides by 15. That got rid of the variable, that got the variable by itself. And 90 divided by 15 happens to be 6. And so then 6 is the solution there. So for number 6, here we have two parentheses. They happen to both be on the same side, but that's okay. Let's take it. So 38, we're going to distribute this negative 2. So that becomes negative 48. That becomes positive 2z. We're going to distribute this positive 3. So positive 3 times z is positive 3z. Positive 3 times negative 3 is a negative 9. Then notice that I'm all on this side. I can combine my like terms. So the 2z, positive 2z plus 3z makes positive 5z. And negative 48 minus 9 makes negative 57. Now that I have this equation, I want to get the variables by themselves. So that means this constant needs to move over with the other constant. So I added 57 on both sides and got 95 equal to 5z. To get rid of that multiplier, I divided both sides by 5. So that got rid of the multiplier. Z is by itself. And 95 divided by 5 happens to be 19. So 19 is the solution there for Z. This problem is a little more complicated. I have fractions. Now, depending on how good you are with fractions, you can use what's called a lowest common denominator. The lowest common denominator between these three denominators is 56. And that is because both 7 and 8 do divide evenly into 56. But notice that that's not the common denominator I used. And the reason is because there are some students that have difficulty identifying what the lowest common denominator is. And so my advice to those that are having that difficulty is, don't worry about it. You don't need to have the lowest common denominator. You just need to have a common denominator. And to make things easy on yourself, if you want to find a common denominator, just multiply all the denominators together. So I took all three of these denominators and multiplied them together, and I got this value. So this is what I'm going to use as my common denominator. Notice I didn't write LCD for lowest common denominator because it is not the lowest. It is just going to work. It's just not going to be the lowest thing that would work. Okay. Now, the goal of multiplying by a common denominator is so that you can eliminate all the fractions. Okay. So what you do is you take that common denominator and put it over 1 and you multiply it to each term. Now, notice where I placed it because that is super important. So notice that I put it in front of this fraction. Okay. So I put my common denominator over 1 times that first fraction. Then I wrote my subtraction symbol. And then I did the common denominator again in front of that next fraction. Okay. And so it's here. And then I did it again in front of the last fraction. Now, all I'm doing for the next step is multiplying the top times the top to give me this and the bottom times the bottom to give me that. Top times top, bottom times bottom. Top times top, and bottom times bottom. Once I have that, I'm just simplifying this fraction in my calculator. When I type that fraction in the calculator, it gives me this number. When I type this fraction in the calculator, it gives me 2744. And when I type this fraction in the calculator, it gives me 56. Notice that I have no more fractions. That was the point of multiplying by the common denominator, was so that you had an equation that no longer had any fractions in it. And it makes it a little bit easier to work with, a little bit easier to identify what's the next step when you don't have all those fractions there. So notice that in this line, there's only one variable term here, and it's on the left-hand side of the equation, which means that my constants need to go over to the right-hand side of the equation. So I added 2744 on both sides. I end up with my variable term by itself equal to this value when I add those two numbers together. And then in order for me to get y by itself, I have to get rid of this multiplier, which means I'm going to divide both sides by that. Again, you don't have to do all the steps that I did by hand. If you type this fraction in your calculator, it will spit out 25 over 16. Let's just verify that. So if I do 2800 over 1792, it does just simplify to 25 over 16. You don't have to try to reduce it yourself by hand. So number 8 is this problem. Again, if I want a common denominator, just multiply the two denominators together, and I got 75. So I did 75 over 1 times the first fraction, my minus sign, 75 over 1 times the second value equals 75 over 1 times x over 5 plus 75 over 1 times 40. So again, top times top, bottom times bottom, I end up with this fraction, top times top, and just a 1 down there. 75 times x, 1 times 5, 75 times 40, and then the 1 down there. So when I type this fraction, it reduces it to 55. This fraction is just 600. This fraction is just 15. And then this fraction is just 3000. Notice that I do still keep my x's, even though it's the numbers that I was typing in the calculator. Once I have this, I notice that I have x's on both sides. So I want to get all my x's to the left-hand side. So I minus 15x over here, and I got 40x minus 600 equal to 3000. If all my x's are on this side, then my constants need to go to the other side. So this guy has to get moved over. I end up with 40x plus 3600. I divided both sides by the multiplier. I got x by itself, and 3600 over 40 is 90. And so the value here for x is 90. Number 9, we got another fraction. So I took these two denominators and I multiplied them together and I got 6. In this case, this is actually the LCD as well. But again, you don't have to think about that on these particular problems. So I took 6 over 1 times that first giant fraction minus 6 over 1 times the 5 equal to 6 over 1 times this other giant fraction. So remember, I have to multiply top times top, bottom times bottom. But you're taking one thing and you're multiplying it by two things. That requires you to distribute. So 6 times x is 6x. 6 times minus 9 is minus 54. And 1 times 2 at the bottom is just 2. This is 30 and the 1 is still there. Here, same thing, 6 times x, 6 times negative 4, and then over 3. Now here's what I did. I did 6 over 2 and I got 3x, and I did 54 over 2 and I got negative 27. Negative 30 over 1 is just negative 30. 6 over 3 is 2x, and 24 over 3 is 8. So I just divided each of these two guys by 2 and divided each of these two guys by 3. And now notice there's no more fractions, right? That was the goal, okay, was to get a problem with no more fractions. Now on this side of the equal sign, I can combine these two together. And so I get negative 57, but I notice I have X's on both sides. So I wanna move my X's over to the left. So instead of positive 2X, we're gonna minus 2X on both sides. And that will give me just 1X or just X. Then I will have to get this constant term over to the other side. So I added 57 on both sides. And I got x all by itself, and negative 8 plus 57 was 49. And so the x value here is 49. Now, they throw in some decimals, but don't let the decimals freak you out. Not luckily, decimals can be typed into our calculator. And so we're going to do the problem exactly the same. So I notice that I have variables here and variables here. I want to move all my variables to that side. So I'm going to minus y. But when I type this in the calculator, remember, minus y means that there's one y. I'm subtracting one y. So in my calculator, I'm actually going to type in 0.87 minus 1. And that's where I get this negative 0.13 y from, because I was combining y's, so I should end up with y's, right? My plus 3, this y is gone, and my negative 0.9. Now I need to get my constant to the other side, so I minus 3 on both sides, and negative 0.9 minus 3 is negative 3.9. So then I need to get rid of this multiplier, so I divided by negative 0.13, which gets rid of the negative and the number, and then I do the same thing on this side. So that number divided by negative 0.13, I get the value 30. Moving on to number 11, I've got some parentheses there, so I need to do some distribution to get rid of it. So 0.5 times 4 is 2, and I left the z. 0.5 times 5 is 2.5, and I brought down my 11.1. 0.6 times 4 is 2.4, and kept the z. 0.6 times minus 4 is minus 2.4. Now here, I had some numbers that could be combined, so I did add those together. And I noticed that I had z's on both sides, so I moved these z's over there by subtracting 2.4. 2 minus 2.4 is negative 0.4. So that's how many z's I have left. My constant came down, this is gone, and my constant came down. Then since all my z's are on the left, my constant needs to go over to the right. So instead of adding, I'm gonna subtract 13.6 on both sides. I end up with the negative 0.4 z by itself, and negative 2.4 minus 13.6 is actually negative 16. So I did get rid of the negative 0.4 multiplier. So I divided both sides by negative 0.4. Here, that's gonna cancel the negatives and the numbers, leaving me with z by itself. And here, if you type this in the calculator, you just get 40. And so 40 is the value for z. Now, number 12 says 4x minus 1 equal to 4 times x plus 6. So we do have parentheses here, so we're gonna distribute that. We get 4x plus 24. I have variables on both sides, so I want to move these over. So I'm going to minus 4x on both sides. But coincidentally enough, they cancel on both, right? 4x minus 4x is, there's no more x's. 4x take away 4x, there's no more x's. So all I have left is negative 1 and a positive 24. But negative 1 does not equal 24. So this is what's called a contradiction, okay? So it's a contradiction when those values, it's false, right? This is a false statement. Negative 1 is not equivalent to 24. When you have a false statement like that, the answer is there's no solution, okay? Now number 15 is another fraction problem. So I took this denominator and this denominator and multiplied them together, and I got 72. So 72 over 1 times the first fraction, my equal sign, 72 over 1 times that 6, the minus sign, and then 72 over 1 times that last fraction. And so then what happens here is that I multiply top times top, bottom times bottom, I get this fraction. Top times top over 1 is just 432 over 1, and 72 times 11 over 1 times 12. Now here, when I put this fraction in the calculator, it gives me 60. When I put this fraction in the calculator, it gives me 432. And when I put this fraction in the calculator, it gave me 66. So this is the equation that we end up with no fractions. Now I do have variables on both sides, so I am gonna move these over to that side. So I added the 66y on both sides. I ended up with 126y equal to 432. I divided both sides by the multiplier, and I got y equal to this. So if you type 432 over 126 in your calculator, it will give you 24 over 7. It just simplifies it for you. You don't have to do it by hand like I did. And then the last question is another one of these. So we're going to have to get rid of our parentheses by distributing. So 0.06 times x is 0.06x. 0.06 times 4 is 0.24. 0.03 times 2x is 0.06x. 0.03 times 6 is 0.18. And then I brought down the plus 0.06. Now these two I can combine. And so I did, I got 0.24 altogether. Now I do have variables on both sides. So I'm going to get these variables over to the other side. So I minus 0.06 on both sides. That just so happened to cancel out both of them. So I have positive 0.24 equal to positive 0.24. Now this is a true statement, okay? So 0.24 does equal 0.24. And so when you get a true statement, it's not a contradiction, it's a true statement. So when you get a true statement, the actual answer is all real numbers are solutions, okay? So if you get a false statement, that's called a contradiction, and it means you have no solution. But if you get a true statement, it means that all real numbers are solutions. So essentially what it means is it doesn't matter what x value you plug in. If you plug in an x here and the same x value there, if I plug in 5 and 5, and I compute this side and I compute that side, they will be equivalent. If I plug in negative 1,000 here and negative 1,000 here, and I compute this and I compute this, they will be the same. That's what it means by all real numbers are solutions. And that is the end of this section. So I will see you, actually no, I got one more. I totally forgot about my last word problem. So we have this problem here. So it says the formula is given here, and it describes the pressure of seawater P in the pounds per square foot at a depth of D feet below the surface. The depth for a certain breath held dive involves a pressure of 184 pounds per square foot. To what depth did the diver descend on this venture? So if they're telling me that 184 is the pound per square foot, then that's P. P is in pounds per square foot, okay? D is not, D is in feet, okay? They didn't give me feet, they gave me 184 pounds per square foot. So that means that I'm talking about P. So P is 184. So I took this formula and I plugged in 184 for P. And so then remember, you've got a fraction here, it's got a denominator of 11, so my common denominator is going to be that 11. So I did 11 times 184, 11 times 15, plus 11 times that fraction. That's going to get rid of that 11 down there. So I'm just gonna have this value equal to this value plus that 5D. Now my variables are all over here on the right-hand side, which means this constant needs to go to the left side. So I'm gonna minus 165 on both sides. I end up with 1859 equal to 5D. And then to get rid of the multiplier, I'm going to divide by 5 on both sides, and I end up with this decimal for D. And so that is the answer for that particular problem. Now I am finished with the 2.3 video. And so I will see you in the next video for the 2.7.